What are you reading?
More Tales of the City, Armistead Maupin.
This is your first or second Armistead Maupin book?
Second one.
Oh. Ian McKellen likes it.
I'm in good company.
He is a gay.
He is a gay.
He's a handsome man. If I dated Ian McKellen, would you be proud of me? Or is he too old and gross?
Well, he's a bit old. However...
Remember the Oscars when he was here?
When he had the candy with him?
Hot.
Yes.
Who would you like to set me up with, though? Bill Maher. He's straight.
Not even straight.
He is straight.
Unfortunate. Somebody clever like that. Somebody...
John Stewart.
If he wasn't married with a child...
I know.
John Stewart, yes.
And if Anderson Cooper wasn't, you know, dating some gorgeous trainer with a perfect body.
I don't think Anderson Cooper is man enough to be out.
Them's fighting words.
I haven't heard him say anything.
Well, I've heard him say things like he wants to keep himself impartial, but that to me suggests that only heterosexuals can be impartial, and I think history proves heterosexuals can't be impartial. With the exception of you. Just saying, them straight folks is shit except for my family. No. What did you think of Short Bus? I know. Isn't that amazing?
Yes. That was different. That was really different. But you know, I felt for people. That was the thing.
I cared about those characters.
It was a movie that got the feelings going.
Short Bus. You enjoyed.
I did. Loved the music.
Oh, the music's terrific.
Loved the music. Felt for characters. And, just... It's good to look at something that you wouldn't normally pick off the shelf.
Well, I remember even thinking when I first saw it, I was a complete... Me and Maddie went to see it, and you know Maddie's in it.
Yay!
And I was just a wreck for 2 hours, because it addressed things that I'd never talked about to myself, and, you know, how we all relate to sex and emotions, and if it's abusive, or if it's indulgent, or if it's self-destructive. And I think it's the first honest film to deal with it. But I was thinking, I don't know, when you said you wanted to see it, I wasn't sure if you'd like it, but I'm thinking, you did live through the 1960s.
Yes, and you know what they say, if you remember them, you didn't live them.
Do you remember them?
Parts. I remember the 60s. I do. Of course I do. Of course I do. I was there. I had a flower in my hair.
You had an afro.
I did have an afro. That was in the 70s,
yes.
I had an afro. Yes, I did. No, but I remember the 60s. I went to San Francisco in the 70s.
You went to the 1978?
Pride. And my first Pride was in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
With your dad.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go.
Who was the first gay person you remember knowing?
Oh, gosh. The first gay person. Well, I think probably the only gay person I knew for a long, long time was Huey. And then through him, once he came out, a lot of his friends.
How old is he when he came out?
Oh, gosh, let me think. 28, something like that.
And this is in the 70s?
Yes.
Or did he come out in the 80s?
No, he came out in the 70s.
Now you moved... Yeah.
And Huey had a first early catastrophic marriage.
Yeah.
And then he dated some women.
Mm-hmm.
But we hung out together a lot. I mean, if neither one of us had a date, we went out together.
Yeah.
And he had a really good group of friends. And... In fact, the lamp, the wicker lamp upstairs in the yellow room,
mm-hmm.
I got from Huey.
You did?
I did.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes, I got that from Huey. Yes, we did a lot of things together, and he was a really nice fellow. So he was probably the first gay person. And
I only have fleeting memories of him.
Yeah, he used to come around when you
tall.
Guys were little.
Or he seemed tall to
he
me.
He seemed tall
little.
To you. He
yeah.
wasn't that tall. But he was a really nice, nice guy. And was in a relationship for quite a while, and then got sick. But, I don't remember knowing anybody gay before him.
Mm-hmm. What spinster aunt did you have?
Oh, gosh. Well, of course, I had my spinster aunt who lived with her lady friend.
Yes.
Yes. And, I used to go spend weekends with them, and we had lots of fun. They were so good to the children. And they shared a room.
Yes, they did.
It wasn't that nice. Yes, my Aunt Alice.
What about your cousin?
Well, my cousin, yes, a bachelor. He also shared a house with another bachelor
friend.
For
how many decades?
Oh, since they were probably late teens.
Was he your second cousin?
No, he was my immediate cousin.
Who faked his age to join his friend in World War II.
Yes.
They fought together.
They did.
Came to Canada together. Got a house together and lived together until he died.
Until he died. Yeah. So I'm pretty sure that they were close.
And if they weren't in love, it was at least that love that best friends
That's
share.
That's exactly so. Exactly so. There's something in this book, and it's a list of its supposedly 10 things that you're supposed to do. Not like New Year's resolutions, but just life-changing things. And the, one of the young gay fellows has 30 things he's going to do. And one of the things he says is that he's going to buy an over 50 a drink one day.
Yeah.
For opening a door.
Yes, and absolutely.
I just think that's such a nice gesture.
Well, I remember me and Maddie were talking about Rick Babu died a couple weeks or months ago, and he was one of the Toronto literature gay pioneer guys, and George Hislop, who was so on the forefront of things in Toronto for decades, who died a couple of years ago. And we used to sit at Statler's piano bar and have cheap cocktails, and they would just talk to us and other young guys who were willing to listen,
right,
about what it was like in the 70s. I don't think some people today realize what had to happen for Church Street or the Village to exist.
Evolve. Yes.
And it wasn't simply just that it always was there. It took effort and it took sacrifice for us to get there. And if everybody who did those sacrifices only thought, well, you know, it's up to my best interests to not be out, none of us would be anywhere.
I know.
There was nobody opening the door for those guys in 1920.
No. If somebody comes to PFLAG and said, our kid came out 10 years ago, and I don't have a problem with it, but I haven't told the neighbors yet, then I'm calling them on it and saying, excuse me.
You do have a problem with it.
I have a problem. You have actually put your kid in the closet.
Yes! You should have one dream for your child, and it's your child is happy.
Healthy and happy.
Yeah.
Do you want her to be happy?
And parents need to also realize if they are being distant because of a sexual issue, I think people not ultimatums per se, but you do need to say in the plainest language, do you want to have a child who is gay or no child at all?
Yes.
Because there is no middle ground.
Well, sometimes parents also have a fear of talking about you being gay because they're afraid you're going to talk about gay sex.
Which now, we've never done.
Well, here's the thing.
Have you talked?
I don't talk about straight sex.
No one.
No.
Well, the letters that a certain person not going to mention got that I read that were filthy from her, like, I imagine you doing all
don't,
these.
Don't.
I'm just saying.
Yes.
I'm just saying.
Yes, don't.
And I was like, lady, do you imagine what your straight son's doing with prairie girls?
You just. And but
barf.
Also at PFLAG, when that topic comes up, well, I just can't imagine them.
Don't.
And we jump in and say. You don't want to be thinking about your straight kids having sex. This is not.
I know, it's
this
so
is,
gross.
This is not normal behavior. You just don't go there.
Ugh.
So, but for some people, it's like it's.
Well, that's what homophobia is. Homophobia is, again, it's so freaking patriarchal. When people in America and Canada think gay marriage, they don't think gay marriage. They think men having anal sex. And I'm like, why are you thinking about this? Well, don't think about it. It's that.
Exactly.
They can't get their heads around it. Then don't think about it.
You know what, Raymond? You don't think about your neighbors that way. So don't think about your kids that way. Don't think about anybody that way. Like,
think about yourself.